orthotopic ureteric meatoplasty, that is Shah's technique for repair of VVF involving the ureteric orifice, or experience. A VVF is an abnormal communication between bladder and urethra, mostly from the obstructed labor in the past. Nowadays, most of them are postoperative due to hysterectomy commonly and other gynec surgery. Incidence of fistula after hysterectomy is 0.1 to 0.2%. Various classifications, and most important here, what we want to emphasize is when the fistula is involving the ureter, so that becomes a technically demanding. There is a need for ureteric dissection and a reimplantation. Ureteric reimplantation warrants additional operative time, morbidity, and obviously there would be small but a definite risk of urine leak and anosmotic stricture. So goal of present study was to provide a rapid, easily reproducible technique for this complex VVF repair and to avoid the need of ureteric reimplantation. That was the basic philosophy in this. Of course, to cure the patient from urine leak, it's just like any other VVF repair. It was a prospective multicentric study from July 12 to August 19. 48 cases were there and VVF were repaired with the orthotopic ureteric meatoplasty technique. The inclusion criteria was one or both ureteric orifice open within 5 millimeter of fistula margin. Sterile culture was ensured as usual. Exclusion criteria was if it is more than 5 millimeter away from VVF, they were excluded. VVF after surgery for malignancy or radiotherapy, they were excluded. A usual evaluation, but here the most important part was the cystoscopy, where we see the size, number, and the distance from the fistulous margin about the ureteric orifice. These are where the various demographies, the size of fistula, even up to 4 centimeter or more than 4 centimeter were also there in some of these cases. In the ureteric orifice involving into the fistula, unilateral was in 38 patients and bilateral was in 10 patients. The demography, otherwise the site of fistula was various things. And some of them were even primary and few of them were even recurrent where a previous surgical attempt was done. The cystoscopy is done to evaluate basically the bladder capacity, fistula size, number, and distance between the fistula and the ureteric orifice. All the procedure were performed transabdominal route as the usual thing. Ureteric catheterization was done. Distance between the ureteric orifice and fistula margin were assessed. Orthotopic ureteric meatotomy or meatoplasty was done. That is incising the anterior submucosal ureteric tunnel for 1 to 1.5 centimeters from the native ureteric orifice along the direction of the ureter. So this is the picture which is showing that the feeding tube is there and then you divide it. And so then this becomes this picture. So this provides us an additional 1 to 1.5 centimeter of bladder wall for safe, easy, and tension-free repair of VVF. And meatoplasty is performed by applying 5 tacking sutures of 40 Vicryl between the ureteric and the bladder mucosal margin, which we have incised. And then further surgical procedure is as usual, nothing abnormal into that. Postoperative period as usual, follow-up protocol as usual, nothing specific into that. Postoperatively, patients were evaluated every 3 months for various things, urine leak, bloods, infective complications, sonography and all that. And the results were that operating time was about 95 minutes. That was the most important aspect in that. Follow-up cystogram, this were done. The cystogram finding was at the end of the 3 months, grade 1 reflux was there in 16%, 16.6%, and grade 2 reflux was in 8.3%. And after 1 year, the grade 1 reflux was in 8.3%, and grade 2 reflux was in 2.1%, and 2 patients were lost to follow up. So orthotopic ureteric meatoplasty is an easy, reproducible, and a rapid technique for repair of a complex VVF. It avoids major additional procedure with theoretically possible complications. And it maintains normal anatomy by preserving intramural ureter so that the theoretical risk of kink and stenosis is avoided. So orthotopic ureteric meatoplasty technique is easy and simple way to convert a complex VVF into a simple VVF and avoids the need for ureteric reimplantation. Thank you.
Lalit, I think that's a good technique of extend, not doing much of a job, just pushing it towards a little more lateral, maybe a little refluxing, doesn't matter. But for that movement, avoiding a ureteric reimplantation is a great idea. I don't deny. I have only one question, basically. Whenever a ureteric orifice gets involved into a VVF area, the whole tissue there and the muscle there is going to be completely be destroyed. So just extending by that way, will you be able to get extra muscle to suture the VVF? I think possibly in some cases it might be possible, but might not be so in every case. What is your comment on that?
No, see, I personally had been practicing this since the last maybe 15 years or so. But since in 2012, we discussed in our Chhattisgarh urology meeting, and then everybody felt that we should do this. And since then, nobody is doing any reimplant. But yes, this is true that all our surgery are abdominal one surgery and omental interposition. And there is no failure so far.
Okay, there are some questions here which have come up on the chat box. The first was, what is your method to assess the distance of the UO from the fistula? Is it only visual?
It's visual.
Okay, so
it's visual during cystoscopy, it is visual, and at the time of surgery, if required, we can measure there.
So there have been instances.
See, the basic thing is that whether we are getting sufficient margin to suture the bladder or not.
Correct. So there have been instances when you found it was not going to be working and you had to reimplant it.
No, not a single one. No, since the idea stuck to our minds.
Right.
I have been practicing this since last 15 years, and there is not a single reimplant that I had to do.
Wonderful, Lalit. I think it's a great idea. Possibly next time we should be seeing it, how it will be possible and how good it will be there. Great idea. Thank you very much for the great. I think you would have presented it as a good video, and next time it would have been better rather than a line diagram. It would have been much better appreciated, and Lalit Shah's technique would have been more popular by this time. Otherwise.
Okay, we would try to do that next time.
Please do this, sir. Thank you.
Thanks. We'll go